There are three different
appellations
of Calvados. The biggest one is Calvados. Here we are in Calvados Pays d'Auge. Mm-hmm. Pays d'Auge, it's a small area with restrictions in the method of production.
Yeah.
And we have in the other part of Normandy, Calvados non fronté, which is made mainly with pears.
There is no like pays. One taste which is like perfect. No. Yeah.
There is lot of taste. Yeah.
20 years old, it's the well-balanced product. You still have fruit taste, and also you have the taste and complexity of a very old alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some people who enjoy smoking cigars enjoy, in general, very old spirit. In Pays d'Auge, 20 years old, it's said to be one of the best age for Calvados.
According to law, we could distill 6 weeks after the harvest, after we press the apples.
Yeah, the juice, yeah.
The cider wouldn't have enough taste, in our opinion.
Yeah.
So we keep the cider 1 year long.
To allow natural fermentation of the cider. Now, and with those 500,000 liters, we will produce something like 45,000 liters of Calvados.
Two distillations,
So you distill it twice.
Twice, yes.
The important is to separate the best alcohol and all the aromas, and you keep only the heart of the distillation.
Mm-hmm.
If you distill it a third or fourth time, you will have more alcohol. It will be stronger on alcohol, but you will have less the taste of fruit. And you see, for example, what we are actually producing is not already Calvados. It's what we call petit eau. In French, petit eau means small water.
Small water.
And it's the intermediary between the cider and the Calvados.
And why you do it with wood?
You know, with wood is the traditional way of production.
Yeah.
And maybe it's a less aggressive heat.
Yeah.
We adjust the fire temperature, opening and closing the air.
The air coming in and out,
All the farms in Normandy used to have apple trees to produce their own cider. And Pierre, my great-great-grandfather, decided to distillate his cider to produce some Calvados. And the barrels are from the time of Pierre Groult. We have never changed them. And you know, the barrels have never been totally empty for the time of Pierre Groult. We add the Calvados when we draft a barrel for bottling.
Yeah.
We take something like half of the barrel, no more.
Yeah.
And we will use one of the eldest we have to complete it.
Yeah.
We let it mature.
Let it mature together.
The name of this method is Solera, Solera system.
You like it?
What do you think about this one?
I think it's the best I ever drank.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Those barrels were bought by Léon at the beginning of the 20th century. And now we use them for our Calvados or blend we call Vénérable. Each year we do our own recipe to try to keep the same taste that the year before.
Mm-hmm.
We want
blend. You have to... Like
to have a good regularity in taste.
Mm-hmm.
He was one of few producers who at this time used to produce aged Calvados. He built this cellar in the 1950s, and he started to promote old Calvados and quality Calvados to change, to fight against the bad image of the Calvados, which was young and strong and not always good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a traditional shape for brown spirits because you have the size large for to turn the alcohol and to air it, but it's closed for the aromas. The alcohol is maybe around, I would say, 16 degrees in the barrels.
Mm-hmm.
At 20, it would be better.
Which is the most thing out of all the job you like the most?
I think what I prefer is distillating.
Distillating?
Yeah. Because it's the the moment, it's the magical moment when you take a cider and you create your Calvados, what will fulfill all those barrels, what will be aged and blended over decades.
Mm-hmm.